Hi guys. Hi. Thank you for joining me. Today, I'm going to be talking about five super common mistakes that all of us make that makes us look older. So before we get into that, I want to launch this poll. Do you feel you look old for your age? And I've activated the poll and I'm waiting for Facebook to show it. Okay. Yeah. Do you feel you look old for your age? And tell me. Because I feel sometimes, I've dressed all wrong and I look old for my age and I've constantly worked on that. So if you feel that way, tell me yes, no, I'm not sure. Doesn't matter if you know it or not, tell me. And also, I love to hear where you guys are watching me from. So tell me if you're watching me live. I'm going live from my studio in West Coast in US. So if you're watching me live, say live and where you're watching me from. It could be New York, it could be New Delhi, it could be Dubai, it could be Dallas. So wherever you're watching me live from. And if you're watching me on replay, just say replay. I love my replay viewers. This video lives on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube. And a lot of you are replay viewers, just simply say replay. And wherever you're watching me from, which could be again San Francisco, LA, Japan, Africa, a continent, wherever. So, wherever you guys are watching me from. And hey, if we haven't met before, hi, my name is Sandhya Garg. You may or may not remember me from Project Runway Season 13, your favorite. Fashion reality show hosted by Tim Gunn, Heidi Klum, Michael Kors, Zac Posen, Nina Garcia. And if you haven't watched my season, go watch it. I was on season 13. It was one of the good seasons that you need to watch. We had Rainbow Challenge, a lot of fashion, a lot of drama, a lot of good stuff. Go watch my season. And if you know someone who loves Project Runway and is having Project Runway withdrawals, tag them in comments below. You can just say at the rate your friend's name and the algorithm will show them this video. And if you want to know what I'm up to 10 years after my season, check out my website. It's www.sandhyagarg.com. And let me know what you think. And of course, follow me on Facebook at Label Sandhya Garg, on Instagram Sandhya Garg 11, on TikTok sandhyagarg.com, on there's so many places. I'm on LinkedIn, wherever, whatever social media network is your jam. On YouTube, Sandhya Garg 7, you'll know my face is gonna pop up. So go follow me. And I talk about fashion, about travel, about fashion tips and advice, and I love to talk to you and engage with you. So if you have any questions, advice, recommendations, feedback, tell me in comments below. If you want to talk about something, I love to talk about fashion. And of course, I have a gorgeous fashion line that is completely custom and exclusive. Go shop if you're going for a wedding, if you're going for a dinner date, if you're going to parties, whatever is the way you celebrate your life, or if you just want to dress up and watch TV like me. Shop on sandhyagarg.com. I make delicious clothing for stunning people like you. So let's dive into five common mistakes that women over 35 or over 30 make that is making us look older than we actually are. And number one is it's so common, hiding our fat bits with loose clothes. Tell me who has done this. If you have done it, I want you to raise your hand up below in emojis or whatever. Give me, a sad face. Just, tell me. Like, if you have hidden your fat bits with loose clothing, I think we all are guilty. It's number one fashion mistake that we make. I used to do the same. I would hide my fat bits and, the days when I'm not feeling super good with some loose clothing, dowdy looking, ugly looking, muumuu kind of dress or a top. But later on, I realized that, you know, it wasn't making me either look good or feel good. So I decided, instead of hiding my fat bits, let me show off my pretty bits. And I am full of flaws. I have so many flaws. You know, with my, I feel there's so much wrong with me. And I know, I think we are harder on ourselves than we need to be. So I decided, instead of hiding whatever's wrong with me or whatever I think is wrong with my body, let me show off whatever I think is pretty about me or whatever I feel good about. So I decided, this is my body shape. And if you don't know what shape your body is, I'm gonna link to a video where you can measure yourself and know your body shape, your body style below. Go watch that video and you would know exactly what your body shape is. And then, you know, if you have any questions, let me know. So first I learned what exactly my body shape was. Then I understood, you know, which parts of my body made me feel confident and look pretty. And then I decided what clothing should I wear that kind of goes with my body, accentuates my body and the features that I feel happy about, and then show those off. So it was as simple as that. And I know it sounds complicated, but you know, it's one and done. Once you know your body shape, no matter you put on weight, you lose weight, it stays the same. Hourglass shape of body puts on weight, hourglass shape wise. A straight body, rectangular shape body puts weight accordingly. So it doesn't matter, the shape stays and the clothing style that you wear stays the same. So I have an hourglass shape and I love my neck, my shoulders, and I love to show off that area. So I wear dresses that fit me on the waist, and then that's about it. And I feel super confident. I don't need to hide anything, and I don't look older than I am. I hope so. I want you guys to guess my age. I am a mom of two, so I'm not a 20-year-old young person. So tell me how old do you think I am? And yeah, instead of hiding, you know, whatever is going on, I like to show off whatever my gifts are. And I hope I'm doing a good job, because I feel fabulous and I feel happy with my styling. So do that. And if you put your body shape below, I'm going to tell you what style looks good on you. And I'll share a link of video where I discuss this. And maybe do a new video about, you know, your body shape and the corresponding styles that you should be wearing. So that's fashion flaw number one. And while I do that, let me also share what I'm wearing. And I'm right now wearing my velvet green dress. I absolutely love it. The bows are in fashion and I have a huge bow. And I know you can't see my entire outfit, but this is a tease, because I want you guys to tap on this link right here, wherever Facebook's put it, and go shop, or link in the comments below. Go take a look on how this dress looks completely on, head to toe, and tell me if you like it or not. So that's what I'm linking to. Now let's talk about common fashion mistake number two, which is wearing wrong colors for your skin tone. Again, I'm going to link a video that I have done about the skin tones that we have and the colors that complement your skin tones. So I have a warmer skin color, you know, I'm on more of a golden skin tone side. And if I wear a steel gray, I look like I'm sick. I look like Morticia Adams from Adams family. I look so dull. So I know I have a warmer skin tone, so warmer colored clothing always complements my skin color. I look fabulous in yellows and oranges, in reds, in all these warm skin tones. Warm skin tones go well with warm colors. So that's what I do. So right now I'm wearing this beautiful velvet dress, which has this pretty warm print, but also it's on muted fall side. So I kind of made it brighter with this bright red lipstick. So if you feel like you are wearing a more dull color, you can always highlight it with a little bit of bright makeup or a bright accessories, you know, maybe do like a nice bright bag, shoes. It's going to be a fashion statement, and it's also going to instantly elevate your look and make you look a lot younger than you're looking in those dull, boring colors that don't complement your skin. So that's one way to correct that problem. But the other way also is to buy colors that complement your skin tone. I talk about a capsule wardrobe that you can create as according to your skin color, and I'm going to also link that video below. So do watch that and tell me what you think your skin color is, and if you are not sure what your skin tone is, put your photo below and I will tell you. Yeah, put your photo below in the comments and I'm going to tell you what your skin color is, so you can shop accordingly or dress up accordingly and look stunning. So that was fashion mistake two. I'm gonna talk about fashion mistake three, which is wearing wrong hemline. Yes, all of us do it. I've done it, you've done it, most of the women I know have done it. We wear weird hemlines that end at weird places and do not work with our legs. You know, sometimes you wear this midi dress that makes your legs look like these stumps of trees, or you wear a mini dress that cuts your body at a weird length. So wearing a wrong length always makes you look so much older and dowdier than you know, you're obviously not. You can look stylish and fashionable no matter your age. So make sure when you buy a mini dress, you know, it's always great if it ends 2 inches above your knee or an inch above your knee. If you it cuts you at your knee, it kind of sometimes look weird and, you know, makes you look older than you are. And like if you have pretty thin legs or shapely legs, do a gorgeous midi. Make sure it just ends mid-calf, or a maxi that ends at perfectly at your ankle length. I have seen maxi dresses that are between ankle and calf, and they look so bad. So don't make this mistake. Invest in a full-length mirror and see where your hemline's ending. And you know, it's so easy to alter a dress hemline. Take it to your local tailor, get the hemline taken up or down depending on where it hits you right. A dress should make you, or an outfit should make you look amazing, and it should, you know, tailor to your body and not the other way around. So you can always take the hemline up or down to make you look absolutely gorgeous and stunning, just the way you are, you know, just the way God made you. So that's how you can fix that problem. Now let me feature this stunning maxi dress, which is a perfect length if you are 5'5". So I figured out, you know, if you're 5'5", or below average height, 5'2" to 5'5", what should be a perfect mini dress length, what should be a perfect midi dress length, and what should be a perfect maxi dress length. I am going to be putting that photo below in after once this video is done, so you can see that. And of course, this dress is the link that I'm featuring, Gaia maxi dress. I know you cannot see the entire dress head to toe, but it is a tease. You need to click on the link, go to the website, check it out, and then tell me how it was. So wearing the right dress length makes a difference. Now let's talk about fashion, most common fashion mistake number four, which is over accessorizing. Oh yes. I think all of us have done it. I see women who put on a pretty dress, then they put on a pretty necklace, then they put on pretty earrings, then they put on pretty bracelets, then they put on pretty rings, then they put on a pretty nails, long nails, then they put on something pretty in their hair, a pretty bag, pretty shoes. It's too much. It's too much. If you when you are dressing up, then you want to look super elegant. Sometimes you need to know how much is, you know, just the right amount of stuff. So right, like right now I'm doing this gorgeous striped dress, which is kind of not super maximal, but it's not minimal either. I'm accentuating it with this matching golden necklace, which is super cute, and I've done it with these simple golden hoops. I could have gone simpler with my earrings. I could have just done studs, and then that's it. I don't need to put on pretty bracelets and pretty rings. It's too much. Sometimes a lot of accessories just doesn't work. And sometimes there are people who can pull it off, like one of my favorite fashion icons, Iris Apfel. She would do probably 100 more necklaces and earrings and bracelets and still look stunning. So that's just another level of maximalism. If you want to go for that bohemian style, go for it. But if you're going to grab coffee and you're not sure how you look, so I would say if you're doing beautiful necklaces, do a couple more and then leave your earrings, you know, simple, and don't put anything in your hands, because you know that kind of elevates the look. It kind of shows off those beautiful necklaces instead of everything that you have in your jewelry chest. So keep it you know, restrained. And if I want to do a bag, I would do a simpler, more classy bag now, so the whole look is very put together, very chic, and not all over the place. So that's common fashion mistake number 4. And talking about minimalistic style, let me feature my one of my favorites, Mughal wrap dress. It's absolutely stunning. And while you take a look at that dress, I'm gonna talk about the last 5th fashion mistake that all of us make. It's pretty common, wrong proportioned clothing. Yes, by wrong proportions, I mean I'm wearing this, you know, nice blouson, super loose top, and I combine it with a nice loose baggy trouser, and that looks super tacky. Or I do this tight fitted top with tight fitted bottoms. I'm not going to a gym. If you're not going to a gym, that's kind of not right looking. So make sure the proportions of your outfit work well. And you can always take a garment to a tailor, because a tailored fit, tailored to your body fit, is always way more better looking, and you know, it's more elevated look than just putting on clothes that don't do anything for your body. And when I talk about proportions, it's also where a dress cuts you at the waist. So a rule of thumb for a natural waist for regular body is about 15 to 17 inches. 17 inches the narrowest part from right here, from highest shoulder point or HSP to waist. So anywhere from 15 to 17 inch. So when you buy a dress that kind of has a stitch or is shaped, make sure it shapes or cuts your body at the right place. If it's too long, it's gonna feel and fall weird. If it's too short, it'll look like an ampere waist. It might make you look pregnant, which may or may not be a good or a bad thing, depending on how you feel about it. So the right proportions matter. Ideally, whenever I wear a nice, you know, a voluminous statement top, I combine it with a tighter bottom. So, you know, my body has this beautiful inverted V shape, which is stunning. And if sometimes I'm wearing these blouson loose palazzo trousers, I want to do them with a nice chic tight fitted, you know, maybe my necks showing, my shoulders showing top. So, you know, it looks like a triangle and it looks beautiful. So we all see each other in shapes. Shapes are such a basic thing, you know, maybe the first thing we learn as kids, and aesthetically very pleasing to our eye if the shape of the body or the outfit you're wearing looks right. So do that, super easy to follow. And yeah, and then putting pieces together, you know, if you want to do a nice pencil fitted, slim fitted trouser, combine it with a nice blazer. If you feel like you're doing a tighter top inside, that again will give you a nice inverted triangle shape. I mean, we are not going for a circle. So think about that. Sometimes, you know, a triangle is super flattering, or even hourglass shape when you go for a pretty dress. You know, if you want to, that's the shape you want to follow. Follow that. So proportionately It should look right. The way the hemline sits on you, the way the waistline sits on you, or how it cuts your body, and of course, how loose your top is or how loose your bottom is. All of these things really, really impact in your overall look. And you may choose style or dressing up or not. I know a lot of people say, I don't do fashion. Which is fine. But it makes a difference when you dress well, when you put on beautiful clothes. It's not for others. I don't dress up because I want to impress someone or look good. I want to impress myself. I want to feel good about myself and confident. I feel like I can win the world, you know, if I'm feeling confident, if I feel I look amazing. So I dress to impress myself. So if dressing up and fashion is your thing, these five common fashion mistakes can really elevate your style and make you look your age or younger than you are. Let me know which one was your favorite out of these five and what are you guilty of from these five fashion mistakes. And do see all the videos that I'm going to be linking below and tell me what else do you want to talk about in terms of fashion. Then don't forget to come back for my Friday Live a week from now. Take care. Thanks for joining me. Bye. Mwah.